Radio 1. another proper New Year's Eve tune there from Frankie Knuckles with Your Love. Happy New Year, everyone. This is Rob DeBank in the Blue Room. Thanks a lot for all your texts. Text us on 81199. Let us know what you've been up to last night, what you're up to now. Thanks to Justine, who switched on at 5:15 and got well confused. Yeah, I know how you feel. Well, we've started a little bit early, and from 6:30, it is The Breakfast Show with myself and Chris Coco. In the meantime, Mr. Knuckles, take it away.
beautiful day. Oh yeah. It's a beautiful day. It's a beautiful day. Oh, oh.
glorious world this could be.
Happy New Year, everyone. Get out of bed, you layabouts, and welcome along to the Blue Room Breakfast Special with me, Rob DeBank, and him,
Chris Coco. And I have to say, thank you, Robbie, for the last couple of hours of mixing. Absolutely lovely it was. Beautiful. I was listening in the taxi on the way over here.
A couple of minor mistakes, but when you get woken up under a desk in Radio 1 in the middle of the night to come and do an impromptu set, you know, that's the way it goes.
Yeah, and the next, how about 3.5 hours we're going to be playing an eclectic selection of music, the sort of stuff that we do on the Blue Room.
Yeah, it's lovely, loads of lovely electronic tunes, folky numbers, little acoustic bits. I mean, normally we're on at the more respectable time of 5 till 7 on Saturdays, but come on, who can stomach Coxie on New Year's Day? So it's us till 10, whether you like it or not. What's up next, Chris?
We're going to start off with a bit of Bent and Magic Love, remixed by Ashley Beadle.
Like a book I read,
wonderfully emotive tune that from Nottingham's finest Bent with their new single Magic Love, mixed by the one and only Ashley Beadle from Express 2. That track from their ace new album, The Everlasting Blink, get your words out, Robert. So what exactly did you get up for on New Year's Eve? Get up to anything naughty or just stayed in and watched Rod Stewart? What did you do, Chris?
I was in Brighton, actually, at the Honey Club, and they were having a Hollywood party.
How sweet.
Which was quite nice. And I saw Harry Potter, he was there. Rambo with a nun. Ali G. Three Indiana Joneses.
Okay, so it's fancy dress, they weren't actually there.
No, they weren't really there. But I've got to say a few hellos, can I do that?
No, absolutely not.
Oh, please.
Only if I can.
Okay, I've got to say hello to Nikki, Big Gay Tom, Wayne the Cowboy, Sheila Blige.
Is that the same Big Gay Tom I know?
I don't think it is, it's another one.
Right.
Apparently, yeah, he's a bit bigger, this one. Okay. And Johnny Nicely as well, and Michelle and Francis, thank you for the coffee.
Well, I'm not going to say hello to anyone yet, because I don't think they'll be up, so... But I was out raving with me chums and the wife at her bar in East London, then DJ'd at Fabric, and then found myself lying under a bench in Radio 1 until I was rudely woken from my slumbers.
Sounds quite nice as well, doesn't it? Obviously, you've got to tell us what you've been up to, because you don't want to hear us rabbiting on about what we've been doing all morning. And you can do that by texting us on this number. It's 81199. That's 81199. Or you can email us if you're very sad and sitting at home with your computer on. And it's theblueroom@bbc.co.uk.
And those emails are already streaming in, as are the text messages. So thanks a lot for those. I believe it's Groove Armada next, your favourite band of 2002, isn't it, Chris?
Not quite, actually. I don't really like them, to be honest.
I don't think you should be saying that on national radio. Anyway, this lovely track, which I think's brilliant, is called Remember, samples Fairport Convention.
Very nice.
And I think it was definitely one of the highlights of 2002, their album. So there.
You see, for remember. The Blue Room on Radio 1. Radio 1. Blue Room Tune. The Blue Room on Radio 1. Radio 1.
In a town where I was born lived a man who sailed to sea, and he told us of his life in the land of submarines. So we sailed out to the sun till we found the sea of green, and we lived beneath the waves in our yellow sun.
submarine. We are all. We are all. We are all. We are all.
Beatles, or the remaining Beatles, make of that. That's Roots Manoeuvre with Yellow Submarine on Ultimate Dilemma. Blinding tune from last year, and before that it was our friend Erland Oy from Norway with Ghost Trains.
He's a man, man.
He certainly is. Not as big a man as Roots Manoeuvre, who should definitely have won last year's Mercury Music Prize, even if only for the black leather tracksuit he was sporting on the night, don't you think?
Definitely. I didn't actually see it, but I'm sure it was lovely.
Yeah, it was beautiful. So it's January the 1st, 2003. Happy New Year, everyone that's tuning in. We've actually been on the air since 4:30 by some fluke, but New Year's resolutions. The wife's begged me to give up on the sprouts, have at least one alcohol-free day a year, And I know Anita, the producer who sat here with us, wants me to speak faster on the radio this year, so I'll give it a try. Chris, you got any resolutions?
No, I've resolved, as usual, not to make any resolutions. I've been reading this guy called The Barefoot Doctor, and he says that what you should do is not make any resolutions because you're only going to break them anyway, but actually let the Tao into your life and let that sort out all your problems for you.
Yeah.
Which I think it's going to work, you know, I can feel it.
Align your chakras and let the Tao in.
Yeah, I'm going to do it and it's going to work and it's going to be a wicked year.
But Chris, we are trying to lose that hippie image that we've got with the blue ring.
I won't tell you what else he said. The other thing you're supposed to do, right, is the other thing you can do, which is a good thing to try, but you have to be careful because it involves matches, is to write down your New Year's resolutions on a piece of paper and then burn it and say that as you burn it, that all things are going to get better.
Ah, very mystical.
All right.
You'll be trying colonic irrigation next.
No, I don't think so.
So what have we got coming up?
We've got lots of wonderful, wonderful music, which is the sort of stuff that we play on the Blue Room with Chris Kirko and Rob DeBank, 5 to 7 on, well, it's Saturday mornings, isn't it?
Yes, it is. It was at the last Saturday, yeah.
And we've got lots of information from people around the country who've been texting us on the number, which is 81199, and they're saying things like this. Easy, Rob and Chris, in the back of a transit van, chilling to your tunes, Dan and the Fish People, somewhere in a field in Dorset.
Interesting, yeah, we've got Davy and pals who say brain ceasing to function, need a shout out, fend off the Daleks. I don't know what they've been up to last night, but I'll have some of that.
I think we should play some more music.
Yeah, take it away.
Next one is one of my favourite tunes of the year from the Bees album, and it's a track called Sky Holds the Sun.
Thank you. Buenas dias, friends. Merry New Year. I'd like to send out a great represent for Chris Coco and for Rob the Bank for Radio 1. Yes, friends, the Blue Room. Beautiful sounds. Chillman, Chillfordian.
Welcome along and happy new year. It is 2003, is that what it is? Is it three?
That's right, that's yeah. Right, Robbie.
Excellent. That was Ceylon Luft from Germany with Manila, with young Mixmaster Mike rapping there, a 12-year-old kid who was discovered in Compton, Los Angeles by Mr. Ceylon Luft and dragged him into the studio and recorded him. And what a lovely rapper he is too, set for a big future, I believe. Next up, we've got The Freezer, where we delve into the distant, refrigerated past of electronic music and pick out a nugget. What have we got, Chris?
Yeah, we've got The Orb and Little Fluffy Clouds, which came out in, 94, I think it was. And Alex Patterson, who's the man behind The Orb, he actually wrote a track called The Blue Room once, coincidentally, which is quite nice. Yeah, and
Are you saying we stole...
I'm saying nothing at all. I'm just saying that he did write a track called Blue Room. And,
got you.
That is the name of our show.
Well, can we dedicate the tune to someone, maybe? I think we should dedicate it to Derek Manson, who's emailed us from Inverness. saying that he's just in, having worked for 12 hours answering 999 calls from the struggling and stranded of the UK. Please big up all the emergency authorities and BT operators who have worked their beeps off tonight, keeping the country going, and perhaps play something by the Streets. Unfortunately not Derek, because we're not big fans, but we will play you The Orb.
That would be nice, wouldn't it?
Yes.
And you can still do, you can email us at theblueroom@bbc.co.uk or you can text us on 81199.
Yes, and don't laugh at us if we make mistakes, because this is our first ever live show.
And it's very early or very late or something.
And
like
we've
that,
been okay. up all night.
Absolutely.
And we're having fun.
The Freezer, The Blue Room on Radio 1. Radio 1.
Stars at night, and when it would rain, it would all turn. They were beautiful, the most beautiful skies, as a matter of fact. The sunsets were purple and red and yellow and on fire, and the clouds would catch the colors everywhere. That's it, neat, because I used to look at them all the time when I fly. You don't see that. We'll be right back.
old school flavour than cheese onion crisp in a blue packet there. Definitely one of my favourite covers of last year. That's Trevor Jackson as Playgroup doing Depeche Mode's Behind the Wheel. And before that was The Orb, Little Fluffy Clouds. We've got some nice texts about that. One from Snoring K, whoever he is. Thank you for The Orb, it's made my morning. And one from D&D in Pompey. The Orb dude, you just completed my moment. Can you give it 10 minutes and put a nice tune to horizontally groove to? Nice one.
I think we can do that, can't we? I've got a nice one as well from Pommy. It says, hello chaps, the wife and I just got back from the cream night in Blackpool's Winter Gardens. Sonique was blinding, especially when she dropped Insomnia by Faithless.
That must have been a marvellous moment.
It must have been, mustn't it?
That's just a shame we couldn't have been there.
It's one of those classic club moments, isn't it, really?
Definitely, yeah. And I'd like to just say a couple of quick shout-outs to my wife to stop bothering me on the text message system. This is a national service for sensible people, not yourself. And to Giddy, Paul and Harriet, all the folks at Will and Luke's, Crackers, Giles, Joe, Colin, my mum and dad and my granddad, who always tunes in, doesn't he, Chris?
He does, actually, yeah. And he listens to my show as well. It's really nice.
All right, OK. Well, you know, he listens to mine first. And
has he still got that funny hat that he
wears? Yeah, he wears a tea cosy in bed and drinks tea.
Wicked. That's lovely. Well, let's dedicate the next tune to him then, because this is a new one. Obviously, on the Blue Room, we play lots of strange new music and electronica and stuff like that. And we got this one from this band from Germany called Pulse Programming, and the album's called Blues Eventually. And the reason that we like it really and truthfully is because the CD cover, which you can hear, turns into this little barn, and it's got two kids running down the side of it, and you have to build it, and it makes a barn, and it's just lovely.
You are such a child.
So if you're online at bbc.co.uk, you can see it on the webcam.
And you can see us as well, all bleary-eyed and a bit messed up at 7:21 in the morning. We're here live.
We are. It's lovely, isn't it? Happy New Year.
Happy New Year, everyone. What have we got?
Thank you. there's nothing we like better than to sit on the beach. It becomes Sunday morning when we hear the Blue Room show. I go out surfing, I come in, listen to some chilled out tunes and get back out there and rock it up. Thanks, Robbie. You forgave us a great year of music. Choice.
What's it called? Trabant, that's right, and Superman, which is... I think that was one of our Blue Room tunes, wasn't it, Robbie?
Yes, it certainly was. Blissful Scandinavian music, as ever. We've got the soundtrack coming up, I believe.
Yeah, tell us about the soundtrack. What's that about?
Well, it's a rather unusual one, this one. I mean, normally it's just a self-explanatory. We play a soundtrack, which has got a rather lovely sort of ambient theme to it, maybe. This one's a bit more up-tempo. It's Prince. It's from Under the Cherry Moon. It's Girls and Boys. And I thought we'd just play...